Mossy Quinn, two brilliant games in Division 1 and Division 2. We've seen Roscommon picked up the Division 2 and then Kerry picked up Division 1. What did you make of Roscommon and Galway in the first game?
Yeah, very exciting game, the first game. In fairness, Galway got off to a great start, some excellent points from play. But Roscommon responded. It took them a little while to get into the game. They were relying on frees and early on in the game. I think it was 25 minutes before they scored from play. But very exciting end to the half. They went in level at half-time, 9 points apiece. And Roscommon were by far the better team at the start of the second half. They opened up a nice lead. But Galway, a couple of introductions. Shane Walsh came in. Damien Comer came into the game a little bit. Paul Conroy continued his good form. And they had 6 points in a row. But brilliant finish from Roscommon to the game. Substitutes made a difference. And Anthony Cunningham would be delighted.
Yeah, he was when I spoke to him just after the game, and they've gone unbeaten, the only team in all the divisions to go unbeaten. That's brilliant for them.
It is, yeah, there's no doubt. And look, even beating Galway back-to-back now in the last 2 weeks. I know last week Galway made a lot of changes, but to then come in here and back it up this week with what is no doubt Galway's strongest team that they could have picked from today. And yeah, he will be absolutely delighted. It was a big performance in the second half, closed out the game. He would have been, again, the subs making a difference, real squad performance, and they showed real quality. They've a lot of attacking threat up front, and they really proved that today.
Yeah, it's great for them. And Galway, on the other hand, you know, they've 2 losses now going into the championship. Will that have an effect at all?
A little bit, yeah, because like they have had a positive league campaign. They've put up big scores. They've scored a lot throughout the league, but again, they're conceding a lot, and that'll be a concern. And coming towards the end of the game today, they got themselves brilliantly back into a winning position. They were a point up going into the closing stage and then give away that goal. And it was a brilliant goal, but from a defensive point of view, he carried the ball a long way. There wasn't a lot of contact on him in terms of getting turnover off him. And Pádraig Joyce would be frustrated with that. I think they need to work on their kick-outs as well. I think there was times where they were going short and they were giving away to kick out certain times, and I think that's something they'll look at, because Mayo will go after that in championship in a couple of weeks' time.
And Shane Walsh, they're heavily reliant on him a lot of the time. He came off the bench today, you know, he kicked a good score. You could see the impact that he made, but are they heavily reliant on him?
Yeah, they are reliant on him, but in saying that, they do have a lot of quality. You know, he did make an impact off the bench. They'll obviously be hoping he'll be fit to start in a couple of weeks' time, and got a good point. But in fairness, they've other leaders. Paul Conroy was exceptional today. Damien Comer, they had some good performances. But yeah, they will be looking for a little bit more around that middle third.
And just to mention Paul Conroy, I thought he was brilliant today. He really stood up, and in that midfield, he really battled, and he just owned it.
Oh, he did, yeah. Right from the start, I think he got 2 of the first 3 points. He was kicking right foot, left foot, and exceptional scores, and all from distance. There wasn't too many straightforward ones. And then in the second half, when they needed to claw back the game, he was one of the leaders driving on, and really standout performance here today.
And Galway going to Castlebar now to play Mayo in the championship. That's not going to be easy.
It won't be, no. And look, obviously, championship takes a life of its own, and you'll see, you'd imagine both teams, based on their performance today, be looking to up it massively as well, you know, and I think that's something the management will be taking over the next couple of weeks.
And for Roscommon then, they await the winners of Sligo or New York. They have about 4 weeks, so they get that extra week really to prepare for that. Are you excited to see what Roscommon will do this year?
Yeah, I think so, and I think that's why their management would be delighted. Like, they couldn't have asked for its ideal preparation. Really strong league campaign, finished brilliantly here with a big performance against Galway, and they are on what would be considered the easier side of the draw, so probably allows them maybe a little bit of a down week this week in terms of training load, in terms of what the team are doing, and even a bit of mental freshness to allow them to come back into championship. So I'd imagine their preparations now, everyone will be jumping off the ground trying to get back into that team come the first round of championship.
And for both teams, obviously both promoted to Division 1, you know, that's great for them, because you look at Division 2 now and it's tough going. Obviously we see Dublin are in there next year, so no team really wants to be in there fighting to get out of it.
No, they don't. It's always, look, Division 2 is always an incredibly tough division, and you've seen that in the last couple of years with the level of performances in the teams. And I think that was Roscommon's 4th time in the last 8 years to win Division 2. They've been kind of up and down all through the last couple of years, so they'll be looking for a bit of consistency to build on it, but that'll be something they'll look at next year.
And just mentioning Dublin there, were you surprised to see them down in Division 2?
Yeah, obviously, like at the start of the year, you would have been surprised to see them relegated. Their level of performance would have been below what they would have been expecting themselves. And while it improved towards the end of the league, they obviously didn't do enough the last day against Monaghan. So I suppose after, it wasn't just a once-off, after playing 7 games, the league table is what it is. So in terms of that, they'd be looking to improve their performances for championship.
And we talk now about the Division 1 game. You definitely could see the difference in intensity and even just physicality really in the game.
You could, definitely. It would stand out from the first 10, 15 minutes. You could see it. Even some of the off-the-ball tackling in terms of the checking, in terms of the contact being made when ball carriers were coming through. And, yeah, there was no doubt that it was a level above. And Kerry were probably a level above Mayo that, and as the game went on, you could see the difference. And I was very impressed with Kerry's work rate today. They got through a massive amount of work through the middle third. Really made it difficult for Mayo. And, yeah, you could see that from the start.
Yeah, it looked quite comfortable. Yeah, a little bit surprising. It looked very comfortable for Kerry.
It was, yeah. They were impressive going forward. They were mixing it up. Their half-back line was excellent. Really gave them a platform driving forward, carrying the ball through the middle. Their forwards were, again, at times were very slick. Clifford and Gainey inside were excellent. Both of them very efficient with their shooting. Paddy Clifford was good. Probably missed a couple of goal chances in the first half, which he'd be frustrated with. Goalkeeper made a couple of good saves, but again, he would have thought he should have finished them. So, you know, Kerry are after putting up a big score here today and will still feel like they left a bit behind them.
And Kerry, just for their defence, you know, that was something we talked about a lot last year. Do you feel that they've sort of improved that now?
Certainly on today's performance they had, yeah. You could see they were tight at the back. What I liked, a lot of their full back line were very, they were making a lot of contact, contesting the first ball, primary ball coming in. So the likes of Ryan O'Donoghue, James Carr, they were really being challenged. They were under pressure, winning that primary possession. And they put in a strong performance. And the likes of Tyke Morley would drop back at times, and they had that plus one. And again, they limited the Mayo attack. And Mayo would be frustrated. They missed a couple of chances themselves. But again, very strong performance from the Kerry defence.
Yeah, there was a lot of turnovers in there, and Mayo a lot of the time opted for that long ball, and it was just being cleaned up each time.
It was, yeah. And again, there was a bit of credit goes to the around the Kerry midfield half forward line. Dermot O'Connor, Jack Barry, they were getting pressure on the kickers. So some of the ball wasn't the best ball coming in, but again, it was being well read. The likes of Tyke Morley, Jason Foley were out in front, and they were winning that ball. And it was wasteful from a Mayo perspective. They look at that video, and there'll be a number of times where guys tried to kick pass in, and it was easily intercepted, and that's something they look to cut out.
And just to mention Paul Gainey, he kicked 5 points. Definitely a player that's really come into his own, and he's really on form in this league.
He is, yeah. And I think last year we saw him, he played most of the league and championship last year at wing forward. And I don't know that it overly suited him. He's very much a finisher for me. He's very much a high skill set inside. And you saw that today. He dovetails well with Clifford. And like you saw the likes of, you know, Dermot O'Connor, Darren Moyne and Adrian Splann. They're the kind of wing forwards, kind of the way the modern game is going, getting up and down, getting turnovers. They'll chip in with a point or two, whereas Gainey for me is perfect for inside, and he showed that today with a couple of really nicely taken scores.
And even the stuff he did off the ball, I was watching him a few times, the way he creates that space, and he has that knowledge and experience, I suppose, to allow that David Clifford to take it on. That's something that's really strong on his end.
It is, yeah. He works well with Clifford, and he also is very smart when there's runners coming through the middle, and he knows when to not fill that space, and he knows to hold out to the side, because he'll either create a gap for the wing back or the wing forward to keep going themselves, or else it'll be popped out to him. So his movement is very clever, and yeah, he's no doubt a high football IQ.
And David Clifford, what do we say? Just a masterclass. We were looking at each other a few times just going, wow, like he really is something else. And it was an interesting battle as well between himself and Porcahora.
It was, yeah. It was good to see it in person, you know. And his movement's exceptional, you know. There's no doubt. Off the ball, when the ball's coming in, he's moving left and right. And O'Hara, in fairness, tried everything, you know. And he was pulling and dragging out him at times. But the strength of Clifford, he showed everything from strength to movement to left foot, right foot. His goal at the end was probably just the icing on the cake. But even throughout his performance, O'Hara went forward himself a couple of times. Looked like he was trying to put him on the back foot. And Clifford identified it. The minute O'Hara went, Clifford had found himself. I think he got himself onto Plunkett once or twice, and the minute it came in, he swung it over and a couple of points. So again, very, very smart footballer, and just really, really impressive display.
Do you do that with a player like David Clifford? Do you go forward? Like, should you nearly be a man marking job? That is it for the day. Like, when I watched him bombing forward, I was like, geez, I don't know if that's what you'd be telling him from the sideline to do.
If he follows you, then maybe there's a benefit in it, in the sense that then he's 70 or 80 yards away from the goal, so it's hard for him to score. But if in that instance where he doesn't track and he passes that runner on to one of the wing forwards, then you need to have someone dedicated to him, because then you have him in the ability to find those little pockets, and then you have a wing back or someone else who's now filtering into marking, which is definitely a matchup you don't want. So if you thought that he was going to follow you, there might be a benefit. But he didn't do that today. He stayed in close to goal. He did work back at times, but predominantly he's the main man up there. He's the target man, and for me, you have to have someone, and to be honest, it's going to be very hard for someone to mark him one-on-one when they have that much space either side of him. You're probably going to need to have someone back supporting and getting a second man in fairly quickly whenever he gets possession.
And the two of them got yellow cards for some off the ball stuff. You know, there was a bit of pulling and dragging going on. But David Clifford, it nearly spurred him on even more, because we've seen him really take it on O'Hara then in a few one-on-one battles.
He did, yeah. And they were at each other a little bit. I'd imagine O'Hara was probably at him a little bit more, you know. But fairness to David, he's a big, strong fella. He doesn't shy away from it. He's well able to use his own physicality. But it seemed to go up a notch there in the last 10 or 15 minutes. They've been at her a bit, but they both got booked, as you said. And, yeah, had a couple of possessions after that. O'Hara won one or two of them. But, again, the goal Clifford got at the end, it was a real individual goal. He knew O'Hara, on a yellow card, didn't have another foul in him. He would have been sent off. And, obviously, when he went by him, and a brilliant finish to the net.
And Kerry now, they're going to play Cork in the Championship. They have a few weeks now to sort of prepare and get ready for that. How do you see that one going?
Well, look, the form Kerry are in at the moment, they're the form team in the country, you know, and there's probably a little bit of off-pitch stuff to sort out between now and then in terms of where the game is played and all that. So that'll probably be a bit of a distraction, not so much for the players, but probably for people building up to the game. But from an on-field performance, Cork have been off it a little bit this year. You saw that they struggled to stay in Division 2, and there's a big, big gulf between where they're at or what they've shown this year and where Kerry are at. I know people will say, look, a couple of years ago Cork caught them on the hop and got the last minute goal in Munster, but it's very, very hard to see anything like that happening this time around.
And is that hard for them? They don't really have, I suppose, these tough games in their provincial rounds, like, you know, being realistic about it.
Yeah, I don't see it as being an issue. You know, even a couple of years ago when there was much bigger wait between the league and the Championship, and Kerry might have had 5 or 6 weeks to wait to play a game, then they might have 3 weeks between Munster Championship games. The fact that they've had 7-8 league games now where they've had against Division 1 high class opposition, and now they only have a couple of weeks to wait going into Championship, I don't see it being an issue. Look, it's hard to see them being challenged too much in Munster, but once they come out of that, probably gives them, similar to Roscommon, probably gives them a chance to have a down week or two this week in terms of maybe give the players a couple of days off, let them get a bit of a break, and then come back in with a freshness, and they know they're going into another bank of work ahead of Championship.
And the league as a whole, have you enjoyed it?
Yeah, I have, yeah. In fairness, like, the quality of football has been excellent. There was huge excitement across, as we saw the final day of the across all the divisions last weekend was excellent. So yeah, very enjoyable league.
And Mossy, yourself, are you still playing a bit of football?
Yeah, trying to hang in there with the club at the moment, yeah. So trying to stay going for the time being anyway.
And how will yous go this year?
We'll see. We're doing our best. We're in a bit of a rebuilding phase. My age kind of skews the average age of the team a little bit at the moment. But yeah, we're trying to get back going again. And it's great to have back. It's the first time in a couple of years there's been a full league in Dublin. So having full league games and championships to look forward to later on in the summer. So it's really enjoying it.
And for Dublin now in Championship, do you think they'll improve things and kick on?
Yeah, well, obviously that's their hope, yeah. Like the Leinster Championship, I suppose, in the last number of years has obviously been fairly one-sided in their favour. And I think, obviously, based on Dublin's league performance this year, you'd imagine the likes of Kildare and Meath and other counties would be looking at it maybe with a little bit more hope this year. So, first and foremost, they have to get their performance levels up within Leinster. And after that, then, they'll be hoping to get a couple of bodies back in terms of carrying a couple of injuries. There's probably a couple of younger guys that they probably would have liked to have had a look at during the league that they didn't get a chance to again through injuries. So, for me, they're still probably looking to try and get that squad back up to 21, 22 guys that they know they can rely on when it comes to Championship. I think that's probably in the last 18 months where they've probably dropped off a little bit, and I think you need that 21, 22 that are going to come in and have the ability to play at a high level later on in the summer.